is what Psalms 56 say. Psalms 56, if you have your Bible, just get it out and we can read together. You may mute your microphone, but let us read together. Psalms 56.
Zaburi ya tano mu mukaga.
Psalms 56.
Zaburi ya tano mu mukaga.
This is what it says. When the Philistines took David in Gath, this is what David said. Be merciful to me, O God, for man would swallow me up. He daily oppresses me. I think the Luganda readers just follow. My enemies would daily swallow me up, for there be many that fight against me, O you Most High. When I am afraid, I will trust in you. In God will I praise his word. In God have I put my trust. I will not fear what flesh can do to me. Every day they wrest my words. All their thoughts are evil against me for evil. They gather themselves together. They hide themselves. They mark my steps when they wait for my soul. Shall they escape by iniquity? In your anger, cast down the people, O God. You tell my wanderings, put you my tears in a bottle. Are they not in your book? When I cry to you, then shall my enemies turn back. This I know, for God is for me. In God will I praise his word. In the Lord will I praise his word. In God have I put my trust. I will not be afraid what man can do to me. Your vows are upon me, O God. I will render praises to thee, for thou hast delivered my soul from death. Will you not deliver my feet from falling, that I may walk before God in the light of the living? Praise the Lord. The Lord is good all the time.
Katonda mulungi ekiseera kyonna.
Yes, even in the midst of times such as these, times of lockdown, times of uncertainty, he remains good. As we were worshiping, I remember the word that Pastor Robert gave us when he had just returned from the U.S.
Bwetubadde tusinza, nzijukidde ekigambo Musumba Robert kye yatuwanga yakakomawo okuva mu America.
And this is what he said, that we must always know the sound of the season, the sound of worship of the season. And we were singing a lot of songs about the Lord fighting for us, about the Lord have victory for us over the last 4 or 5 months.
Era ne tutandika okuyimba ennyimba ezikwata ku Katonda okutulwanirira obuwanguzi obuli mu Katonda nga tulwaniridde okumala emyezi mingi.
That was the sound of the season.
Eryo lyali eddoboozi ly'ebiro.
Because we did not know that we were going to enter into another season like this one.
Tetwamanyanga tuli bakuyingira mu biro ebya bye tulimu nga bino.
But church, I want to encourage you this morning.
Naye nkya ya leero nkuzzaamu amaanyi.
God has got your back.
Katonda ali wamu nawe.
You are not left alone, church.
Toliwe katolekeddwawo.
You may be alone in the house where you are now.
Oyinza okuba ng'oliwe ka mu nyumba mw'oli essaawa eno.
But you're not alone.
Naye toliwe ka.
We thank God for another Sunday morning, the 11th of July. And we are yet again to enter into another session of the Word of God. I just want to remind you that we agreed that on the 14th of July,
njagala kujukiza nti twakanya nga 14 omwezi guno gwo musanvu keno.
That is the 14th week ends on the 14th of July.
Wiki eya kumi n'ennya egwako nga kumi na nnya omwezi guno ogw'omusanvu.
Those of you who know you around in April.
Mwabamanyi mumanyi mujukira Apostle Atria teyalagula mu April bwe yajja ku church.
The Lord says he's releasing something mighty, then we believe the Lord for something mighty this week to be released.
Katonda yagamba agenda kusumulula ekinene era tukiriza agenda kusumulula weekend no.
For the 14th of July, that service of that we'll have on that day.
Service yetu joko wana yoku rock satunga kumina nyomwezo gomu sambo jakuwa ya anja ulo nyodala. Nkusabole mekwe la vida luna kuoro.
So that we can move together into what God is doing.
Tutambulilo wa mumu echo katonda chakola.
Amen.
Amina.
And without further ado, I want you, church, together with me, let's welcome our pastor, Robert Kasozi, to share the word that the Lord has put on his heart.
Amen. Amina.
Pastor Robert, we cannot hear you.
Hello, Maya. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, now we can hear you.
Hello?
Hello? Hello?
I believe we are seeing what we call a transition. We are seeing a transition taking place.
I
the change.
Wetegeke okusinka n'enkyuka kyukejja.
Change is going to replace some people, displace some.
Enkyuka kyuke genda kubako bekyusa, egenda kuba bejjamu bifeetekewo abalala.
Will be promoted, others will be demoted.
Abamu bajja kuzibwa, abalala bateekebwa wansi.
And a lot of things are going to be happening.
Era bintu bingi nnyo bigenda kubaawo.
Happening right before
your eyes.
Church, I am really excited for what God is doing. Looking at the picture, the technical team, the committee, the technical team of the committee, the building committee have been doing. It's exciting. We are going to construct our sanctuary.
Nkubulira tugenda kuzimba yekalu yaffe.
Going to be state of the art construct building. It will be stand up.
Kigenda kuba kizimbe ekyewunyisa ekigenda okuzimbibwa n'obukugu.
It is going to stand out in the community of Kawempe.
Kigenda kwatiikirira mu Kawempe.
Is of God.
Nyumba ya Mukama.
It's going to build a city around.
Katonda genda kuzimba ekibugo kutwetoloola. Amina.
Last Sunday I started talking about the ways of God.
Sunday wadde natandika okwogera ku nkola za Katonda.
Give you an example of the life of Moses.
Nemba w'ekyokulabirako ky'obulosa.
So the Bible says.
Bible yegamba.
And he showed his Moses. He showed his ways to Moses.
Yalaga makubo ke eri Musa.
His miracles to the children of Israel.
Eri abana ba Israeli.
So But like Isaiah 55 says,
Musa yatuka okumanya Katonda nga Isaya 5:5 bwagamba.
Our thoughts are not his thoughts.
Ebirowoozo byaffe si bye birowoozo bye.
His ways are higher than our ways.
Amakubo ge gasinga agaffe.
But his ways are the ways that we should seek him to find them for our generation.
Kituyina okunoonya
Mukama buli mulembe okuzuula amakubo ga Mukama ag'omulembe gwaffe Katonda kyakola mulembe gwaffe. Are you able to hear me?
Yemsonga.
So today I just wanted to share something about the life of Moses.
Leero njagala kugabana ku bulamu bwa Musa.
What God can do with a man he has taught his way.
Katonda byasobola okukozesa omuntu gwalonze.
Let's open our Bibles in the book of Exodus chapter 3.
Katubikule mu Bible okuva esula asatu.
Chapter Exodus. Esura satu okuva ku nnyo lusooka. The Bible says, chapter 3.
Okuva esura ya kusatu.
And verse 1. Can I read? In English. Now Moses kept Jethro, his father-in-law, the priest of Midian, and he laid the flock to the backside of the desert, and he came to the mountain of God, even to Horeb. And the angel of the Lord appeared unto him in a flame of fire out of the midst of the bush. And he looked, and behold, the bush burned with fire, and bush was not consumed. And Moses, I will turn aside and see this great sight, why the bush not burnt. And when the saw that he turned aside to see, God called unto him out of the midst of the bush and said, Moses, Moses. And he said, here am I. And he said, draw nigh, draw not nigh here, but put off your shoes, for the place where you stand is a holy place. I'll right there for now.
And so can come out.
But this is Moses. You remember last week we say that he fled Egypt.
Musa yalisa Misiri.
He had killed an Egyptian.
Yali asomu Misiri.
And the Pharaoh found out.
Era Pharaoh na chizula.
Remember, there are something that the Bible does not tell us, but Moses was a prince in Egypt.
Bible yaina cheta tugamba nga Musa yali kabona mu Misiri.
Yali mulangira.
Yali mulangira mu Misiri.
A line among those that could inherit the throne of Egypt.
As
you know, in a succession line, there are always friction and conflict. And so there was that he was a Hebrew.
Yali mwebulania.
Others that were in line to take over from the fellow, but Moses was also a candidate.
Mubanji abaliwo okusikira Namulondo ni Musa yalimo.
So when there was a criminal case against him, they had to kill him. That's why he left the country.
Kati omusango ogwa nagomola bwe gwamuliko bali baagala kumunoonya yensonga lwaki yadduka okuva mu nsi.
And so when he left, you need to understand there are something that happened in our lives.
Oyina okutegeera nti waliwo ebintu ebituuka mu bulamu bwaffe. Waliwo ebintu ebituuka ku bulamu bwaffe.
God usually takes everything and turns them around for our good.
Bulijjo Katonda akyusa ebintu ku lw'obulungi bwaffe.
Not a good report that Moses killed a man.
Teyali ripoti nnungi nti Musa yali asse omuntu.
God used it to pave a way for him to go to Midian to the house of Jesse.
Katonda yagikozesa okumukubira ekkubo agende Midian mu nyumba ya Yesero.
And he was with Jethro for 40 years.
Era yamala ne Yesero emyaka ana.
Remember, Jethro is a great grandson of Abraham. Excuse me.
Era jukiranga Yesero yali muzukulu wa Ibrahimu.
His father Midian was the son of Abraham.
Kitawa Midiani yali mutabani wa Ibrahimu.
And so for all those 40 years, Moses sat under the feet of Jethro, learning about God and his history as a descendant of Abraham.
Era okumala emyaka egyo amakumi ana yatuula ku bigere bya Yesero n'ayiga ebintu bingi by'ayina okuyiga ebikwata ku buzaaliranwa bwe ne ku Katonda.
In the chapter we have read,
mu ssuula mwe tusomye,
God himself decided that I need to introduce myself to Moses because I'm going to
Katonda mwene asalawo okweyanjula eri Musa kubanga yali agenda mukozesa.
Moses is 80 years old.
Musa yalina emyaka 8.
He has never met God face to face.
Naye nga tasinkanangako Katonda maaso ku maaso.
All he knew about God was what was told.
Be yali amanyi ku Katonda byebyo byali byamugambibwa.
In Egypt,
mu Misiri,
God had his purpose to deliver the children of Israel from slavery.
Yazula ekigendererwa kye eky'okununula abaana ba Isirayiri okuva mu buddu.
And then the 40 years he spent with Jethro.
Emyaka ana gye yamala ne Yesero.
He was taught about God.
Yayigirizibwa ku Katonda.
But in chapter 3, the Lord meets him face to face.
Naye mu ssuula ey'okusatu Katonda amusinkana maaso ku maaso.
What God would do with a man he taught his ways.
Katonda ayinza kukoza ki omuntu ng'amuyigiriza amakubo ge.
One, he will reveal himself to that man.
Ekisookera ddala Katonda yeeraga eri omuntu oyo.
Doesn't matter who has taught you or who has discipled you or who has mentored you.
Si nsonga ani akuyigiriza, ani akusumbye oba ani akukuzizza.
Point, you are going to have a personal experience face to face with God.
Oba ino kufuna ensisinkana ya muntu ku muntu ne Katonda.
I'm telling you, church, if you are going to be used of God, if you are going to walk with God,
kubulira bobo ogenda kukozesebwa Katonda era ng'oli wa kutambula ne Katonda,
after you sat under your mentors, under your disciple mentors, people that are teaching you things,
ng'omaze okutuula n'okkakkana wansi w'abakuza ne bakuyigiriza ebintu.
The practical lesson of discipleship is experiencing the presence of God for yourself.
Enkola eriwo ey'okulaba Katonda ayina okusooka okweraga nga y'enkola ey'okuyigirizibwa esookebwako.
No longer reported speech for you, but is experience that's part of your life.
Nga tebikyakugambibwa bugambizi naye oba wakiyitamu nga wakirabako.
The Bible says Moses is keeping the sheep of his father-in-law.
Bible yagamba nti Musa yali akuuma ndiga za sezaala we.
It's God in a burning bush.
Nasinkana Katonda mu kisaka ekyaka n'omuliro.
And God emphasizes the burden that Moses faced before he left Egypt.
Era Katonda akatiriza omugugu Musa gwe yayina bwe yali ava e Misiri.
He said, I am raising you up to go and deliver my people.
Namugamba nti nkukuza ogende onunula abantu bange.
There comes a moment, I want to emphasize this to the church. There comes a moment every one of us must have an experience with God face to face.
Kino nkikkatiriza ekkanisa. Fenna tuyina okuba n'ensisinkana eya Katonda maaso ku maaso.
This is the fundamental. If you are going to walk with God, if you are going to be used of God.
Kino kyankizo nnyo bw'oba ogenda kutambula ne Katonda era ng'ogenda kukola naye.
It is being called nowadays, this fading generation.
Kizibu nnyo okukiraba mu mulembe guno oguggwaawo.
People have been quoting the man of God, my pastor, my prophet, the man of God is saying.
Abantu bulijjo bajuliza nti omusajja wa Katonda omusumba wange nabbi yangambye bwati ne bwati.
We are going back to where God said.
Naye kati tuddayo eyo Katonda gye yayogerera.
Back to the book of Jeremiah and the word of the Lord came to me.
Dayo mu Yeremia ne Ezekiel wagambira nti ekigambo kya Katonda ne kijja gye ndi.
We are going back to the book of Revelation where the Lord joined in a physical form.
Tugenda kuddayo mu kubikkulirwa Katonda we yayogera ne Yokana maso ku maso.
It's time for some of us to meet angels face to face delivering the messages of God in our houses and homes.
Kye kiseera tusinka ne bamalayika mu nju zaffe maso ku maso nga batuwa obubaka obwaffe ng'amaka.
Business of elevating men and creatures of God to a point of blocking God's sight for some of us is getting over church. God is changing his things.
Bino eby'okususuuta abantu okuyimusa abantu nga baziyiza Katonda kyakola mu bulamu bwaffe ebyo ebiseera biweddeko.
Yes, we are going back to thus says the Lord.
Tuddayo wali okugamba nti bw'ati bw'ayogera Mukama.
That does not put down the jesseros of this world.
Ekyo tekikkakkanya bayessero b'ensi eno.
It's a practical thing, it's a practical part of what they've been teaching us over the years.
Naye nga ge gamazima ag'ebintu byebadde batuyigiriza emyaka gyonna.
You have sat under men and they have instructed us.
Kituufu tutudde wansi w'abantu ne batuyigiriza bingi.
But church, nothing beats the experience of meeting God face to face and hear his voice.
Naye tewali kisinga oba kijjawo nsisinkana ne Katonda maaso ku maaso.
When we elevated men in the place of God in our generation.
Tubadde tuyimusa abantu mu kifo kya Katonda mu mulembe guno.
That's how we got fake pastors, fake prophets, fake apostles, fake that, fake everything.
Omwe mwe mwava abannabbi ab'obulimba, abasumba, abafere n'abantu abalala bwe batyo.
But I can tell you, no one can play God in your life.
Naye nkubuulira teri ayinza kusinga Katonda mu bulamu bwo.
When a person meets God face to face,
omuntu bw'asinkana Katonda maaso ku maaso,
that experience alone,
ensisinkana eyo yokka,
will change your life forever.
Ekyusa obulamu bwo emirembe gyonna.
Transform you into another man.
Okyusibwa n'ofuuka omuntu omulala.
Raise your face to another level.
Eyimusa okukkiriza kuneekuteeka ku ddaala eddala.
We're about a generation that does not run after men, but run after the mountain of the Lord to meet God face to face.
Tunatera okulaba omulembe ogutanoonya bantu naye nga gunoonya Katonda musinkana maaso ku maaso.
What will the Lord do with the man he has taught his ways?
Katonda ayinza kukolera ki omuntu gw'ayigiriza amakubo ge?
To show himself strong on behalf of that man.
Yeyolekanga w'amaanyi eri omuntu oyo.
He will reveal himself who he is.
Ajja kweraga ki kyali gy'oli.
For God comes to Moses and introduces himself as a God of his descendants.
Katonda gy'eri Musa ne yeeyanjula nga Katonda w'abajjajja be.
Because remember, Moses had lived in Egypt for many years.
Jukira Musa yali amaze emyaka mingi nnyo mu Misiri.
It has the name.
Katonda
wo bush that was not burnt.
Eddoboozi we lyava mu kisaka ekyali kyaka n'omuliro nga tekisiirira.
Moses said, if I go back to the people that you are sending me, what shall I say your name is?
Musa namubuuza bwe naddayo eri abantu b'ontumye n'abagamba nti gwani.
And God said, tell them I am who I am.
Era Katonda namugamba nti bagambe nze.
Ndi.
Nze ndi.
I mean, what kind of name is that?
Bannange erinnya lya kikula kyeryo.
But there was no way God was to describe himself to in the mind to a mind of a limited mind of a man.
Tewali yasobola kwennyonnyolamu eri omuntu alina obuwongo obufunda.
I to give him a description, a description. I am who I am.
Nga tayinza kumunyonnyola kisingako awo yamugamba nze ndi.
God introduced himself as this vast being that has no limit.
Katonda ye yanjulangono munene atalina komo ne wankubadde chikugira.
This is where we get faith that moves mountains.
Eno ye nsibuko yokukiriza okusigulikulula ensozi.
When you meet God face to face,
bosinkana Katonda maso ku maso,
you know his greatness.
Omanya obukulu bwe.
And you know his power, his might.
Olegane kumanyige no buyinza bwe.
Nothing in this world that you can't do.
Olo ne watabawo kintu kyonna mu nsi kyatayinza
kukola. God face to face.
Bobango sinkanye Katonda maso ku maso.
Like Apostle Paul said.
Nga Apostle Paul bwe yagamba,
I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me.
Nti nyinzisa byonna okuyita mu Kristo ampa amaanyi.
A man meets God.
Omuntu bw'asinkana Katonda.
He dominates, he starts to dominate creation.
Atandika okufuga ebitonde byonna.
Moses asked who God his name.
Musa yabuza Katonda erinnya lye.
And I'm telling you, church, if you are going to go out to do exploits, greater things for the kingdom of God,
bobo oli wakufuluma okukola ebinene okunyaga eminyago ebintu ebikulu mu Katonda,
your personal experience, the visitation that he gives to you as a person, will be your confidence to the challenges that you are going to face.
Ensisinkana gye wafuna ne Katonda bwe ganaabeeranga amaanyi go gwe okuwangula byonna by'onoosinkana.
Number two.
Ekyokubiri.
What will God do with the man he has taught his ways?
Katonda akozesa ki omuntu gw'ayigiriza amakubo ge?
He will use him to deliver a nation.
Ajja mukozesa okununula eggwanga.
Oh, this gives me exciting, church. I'm sitting as I was writing these notes down. I was remembering the call on my life, the call on our ministry, the call to each one of us listening on this platform.
We
live in a time when God is drawing his attention to nations, not just a small group of people, but God is drawing his attention to nations.
Tuliwo mu kaseera nga Katonda afaayo nnyo eri amawanga, si bantu naye mawanga.
And there will be a generation that seeks God for nations.
Era omulembe guno Katonda gwakyusa omupya gwaleeta gugenda kubanga guluubirira mawanga.
When God, it took 40 years.
Chatwale emyaka makumi ana eri Musa. Katonda okuteekateeka Musa.
And the final test was that God will have to meet Moses face to face.
Ekigezo ekyasembayo kye kya Katonda okusinkana Musa maaso ku maaso.
And now it was during that meeting
era mu nsisinkano eyo
that God gives Moses specific instruction on what Moses needed to do with his life.
Katonda mwe yamuweera ebiragiro eby'engeri gy'alina okutambuzaamu obulamu bwe.
He tells him in verse 8.
Amugamba mu lunyiriri olw'omunaana.
Exodus chapter 3, verse 8.
Okuva 3:8.
The Bible says, so I have come down to deliver them out of the hand of the Egyptians.
Kakano nzize okubanunula okuva mu mukono gw'aba Misiri.
And to bring them up from the land to a good and large land, to a land flowing with milk and honey, to a place of the Canaanites and the Hittites, the Amorites, the Perizzites, and the Hivites, and the Jebusites.
Era nzize okubajja mu nsi eyo okubatwala mu nsi ennungi engazi ekulukuta n'amata n'omubisi gw'enjuki omuli Abakanani, Abakiti, Abamoli, Abaperezi, Abahivi, n'Abajebusi. Ebyo biseera binyuma bannange. Waliwo ebiseera Katonda mw'anaatumira bamalayika.
Shows dreams and sends prophets.
Katonda walagira ebiroto natuma bannabbi be.
In verse 8 he says, I have come down. I'm telling you, church, there comes a moment when God is no longer sending prophets or angels.
Waliwo ebiseera we bituuka nga Katonda takyatuma bamalayika newankubadde bannabbi.
He comes down himself. Exciting. I believe that those are the times you are entering in.
He's
going to move himself. Stop seeking men of God. Seek God. Don't go from this mountain to another mountain. Go to God.
Tova lusozi kulusozi wabula gende eri Katonda.
Stop tuning on radio, listening to people. Listen, go in a closet and listen to God.
Mulekerawo kuteka ko radio okuwuliriza abantu gwesibire mu kasenge ononye Katonda.
Off that phone, switch off that radio and seek God, and because he has come down.
Esimu eyo jijeko, radio eyo jijeko ononye Katonda kubanga mwene yejide.
Banange simba singamba de manyino ruddama nandi bibagambye mu ruddama bamulunyankole bi.
I wish I knew ruddama or lunyankole or Chinese. I would have taught you in that language.
Which other language I need to emphasize? Katonelaga ntinzize.
The Lord said, I have come.
Basoka bagamba batya ntinzize.
Ndide.
Hey, era kye kimu n'abakyoli.
Even the Choli say, I have come down. The one who is saying, I've come down is not Jesse. It's not an angel. Not the pastor, not the apostle, not the so-called men of God.
Katonda yenyini yagamba Musa ntinzize.
God himself is telling Moses that I have come down to deliver.
Sebone banyabo njagalo balabula nti Katonda tajira bwerere.
I'm warning you that the Lord does not come to deliver in vain.
Katonda tamaka.
The Lord cannot just come down.
Amina abo Luganda zijukira eyo mu myaka gy'ekinana twalirwa mu lutalo lwa Robert de Museven.
I remember in the 80s where there was a war between Museveni and Obote.
Ebatuga nenga tuli mu matwale ga Museveni abali bayekere bisere byo nga bawambe kitundu kyeluwere ekyo.
We were in Luwero, a territory belonging to Museveni.
Ebatu gama nti Museveni agenda kujja ku lwokusatu.
They told us that Museveni would come on the Wednesday.
Banange twakungana.
We all gathered.
Nga ffena twagala kulaba ku Museveni obaddala gyali oba batulimba.
Yearning to see Museveni, whether he was there or it was just a myth. We waited for him since 9 a.m., but he came at around 5
p.m.
We became hungry, but none of us would move
away.
We all desire to see Museveni who would turn into a cart, a snake, who would move through air and other things.
But the one
who speaks to us in verse 8 is not like him.
I pray that he comes to your house.
I
pray that he comes to your family.
I pray
that he comes and touches everything around you.
Every
time God has left heaven to come down, he has come to deliver the oppressed, the poor, those who are suffering under
injustice.
Yes.
May God deliver Uganda from all the hands of the false prophets. May God come and deliver the church from all the crooks who have been chasing away their wives and marrying other women. May God deliver the church from all the false people who make them sell their properties and run away with them. I've told you the Lord is a God of time and season.
This is the fulfillment of a prophetic word that was given to Abraham.
Four 400 years ago.
And the prophetic timeline fell during Moses' time.
He came
to deliver. And he said, I am going to bring them up to a land good and large. God will take his people from glory to glory. Telling you, for those of you that have been thinking that God has come to destroy, destruction is for the wicked. But for the righteous, their first portion is salvation, deliverance. These people had suffered for over 400 years in slavery. They were taken advantage of. They had no voice. They could not speak for themselves. God said, I have heard their cry.
Naye Katonda n'agamba mpulidde okukaaba kwabwe.
God taking them to a place of the Canaanites.
N'agamba nti mbatwala mu kifo ekirimu Abakanani.
Church, listen to me really carefully.
Mumpulirize bulungi.
The places where God wants to bless you are already occupied. But God is going to kick them out because he has come down.
Naye Katonda agenda kubafulumya abagobe kubanga mwene azze.
I'm praying that the Lord will give us Kawempe in Jesus' name.
Nsaba Katonda tugwe Kawempe mu linnya lya Yesu.
Bannange abantu abasamira ne basinza bakatonda b'Abayindi ne babaleeta ne bazimba akedi mu kibuga babo be Bakanani abawedde emirimu.
People who practice sorcery and bring the Indians into the city to put up a kids, they are the Canaanites.
Abantu abasaddaaka abantu.
Those who sacrifice and slaughter people.
Abo be bafuga ekibuga kyaffe Kampala.
They are the ones ruling over Kampala now.
Olowooza nti Katonda agenda kutondayo ensi endala eyitibwa Kanani, agenda kuddira eno yennyini gye tulimu, agigobemu abasamize, abanyazi, abasaddaaka abantu, agikwasa abamutya.
Do not think that God is going to create a new world called Canaan. He's just going to use this very Uganda where you are, and he chases out all the bad people and make you inherit it.
Some of you are wondering how this will happen.
Abamu mwebuza, bino binaba bitya.
Those seven nations in Canaan were stronger than even Egypt put together.
Amawanga ago musanvu mu Canaan gali gamanyo okusinga ne Misiri senga gagattiddwa wamu.
They were numerous, they filled the land.
Bali banji nga bajjuza ensi.
But God saw that he's going to actually take these so former slaves from Egypt and bring them into the same land those people were occupying.
Naye Katonda yalayira nti agenda kuwata bana abantu bennyini abali mu Misiri abatwale mu nsi ezo zennyini omwali abo abantu.
Ladies and gentlemen,
abaami n'abakyala,
welfare transfer is not going to happen for the first time. It has already happened here in this chapter.
Okukyusa okw'obugagga tekugenda kubeerawo mulundi gusooka, kwali kwadda nga musula eno mwe tulabye.
Katonda ddira abantu abatambulidde mu bubi ne banoona erinnya lye ne bavumisa erinnya lye n'abajjawo ensi zaabwe n'azisikiza abatuukirivu.
God gets people who have been evil, he destroys them and gets their wealth and gives it to those who have been righteous.
Church, God has come down.
Ekanisa Katonda azze
deliver his people.
Okununula abantu be.
Inherit the land.
Okusikira ensi.
Ladies and gentlemen,
abami n'abakyala,
wait for this moment.
Nindirira kaseera kano.
You need to raise your faith for this moment.
Oyina okuyimusa okukkiriza kwo ekiseera nga kino.
What will God do with a man he has taught his ways?
Katonda yetaza ki omuntu gwayigiriza makubo ge?
God will promote that man.
Katonda akuza omuntu oyo.
In verse 16.
Mu lunyiriri lwa 16.
In verse 16 of Exodus chapter 3.
Okuva esuula y'okusatu olunyiriri lwa 16.
The Bible says, go and gather the elders together and say to them.
Agamba nti genda okunganye abakadde ba Isirayiri era obagambe nti
God, the God of Abraham, of Isaac and Jacob has appeared to me saying.
Mukama Katonda wa ba Isirayiri, Katonda wa Ibrahim, Isaac ne Yakobo andabikidde n'agamba nti
I have surely visited you and seen what's done to you in Egypt.
Era nkulabye era nendaba ebikoleddwa kugwe mu Misiri.
God did not send a spy, he came himself to see.
Katonda teyatukuma muntu abege ye mwene yakanalaba.
Remember, at this moment it's been 40 years since Moses left Egypt.
Jukira jali jiweze emyaka ana nga Musa avudde mu Misiri.
But God himself introduces him to the elders of the nation.
Katonda mwene namwanjula eri abakadde egwanga.
There are something that God has spoken over our lives.
Waliwo ebintu Katonda byayogedde ku bulamu bwaffe.
It will not come to pass.
Tebijja kutuukirira.
Until we meet the elders of a nation.
Okutuusa nga tusinkanya abakulu mu gwanga.
Because those elders have the key to our to the fulfillment of that which God has spoken over us.
Kubanga bakulu abo era bakadde balina ebisumuluzo ebitutwala mu ebyo Katonda byatogeddeko.
And they are not approachable.
Atenga siba nguba kusinkana.
They travel, they move around in convoys, they are protected by the police, heavy armament.
Batambulira mu bukuumi obwa waggulu ennyo nga beetooloddwa emmundu.
But God himself will introduce us.
Ne Katonda mwene ajja kutwanjula gye bali.
Self introduced you to that group of leaders.
Katonda mwene yajja okwanjula eri abakulembeze abo.
If you're going to do anything in the nation, let us sit at the gate of the city. They make decisions for the city. There is nothing you can do until they embrace what God has spoken to you.
Toina chosobola kola okujjako nga bakiriza era nga baniriza Katonda kyayogedde nawe.
Many people have manipulated themselves and introduced themselves.
Bantu banji bagezezaako okweyiiya ne beeyanjula.
But God will introduce us in Jesus' name.
Ayefe Katonda ajja kutwanjula mu linnya lya Yesu.
By manipulation, by power or any wisdom.
Nga tayise mu kufera maanyi oba na buyinza na magezi gonna.
You don't have to buy them anything.
Toyina kubako kyozina kusoka bagulira.
All you need is to for the Lord to go before you to introduce you as a man he has chosen you for the very hour.
Choka chewetaga ye Katonda kukulembera era kwanjule yongo omuntu gwalonze obwekiseera ekyo.
Amen.
Amen.
What God do with the man he has taught his ways?
Katonda yagazaki omuntu gwayigiriza makubo ge.
He will provide for his needs. God has all the resources that you need to execute your
calling.
We need about $2 million to build the sanctuary we want to build. Where will that money come from? Because we have met God in a burning bush. These instructions shall take us to a place where resources are kept. In verse 22, the Bible says, but every woman shall ask of her neighbor, namely, of how those near her house, articles of silver, articles of gold, clothing, and you shall put them on your son and on your daughter. And you shall.
Boy Mokazi, Alisaba Mulirwana, we, Obo Mokazi, and na, Avera Monjuye. Ebintu ebya feza ebya zabu na buli lugoye era buli kintu kinateekebwa ku batabani bo ne bawalabo era muli nyaga abamisiri.
This is what we call wealth transfer.
Kino kye tuyita okukyusa okw'obugagga.
Gold and silver,
zabu ne feza,
they have always represented the riches and the wealth of every nation. And God is telling them, do not go and break into their houses. Don't use swords or force to take their properties. Go and ask.
You
know what that is called? Favor.
Kuganja.
When the Lord favors you.
Katonda wakuteka kwa kuganja.
When your enemies shall provide for your need.
Nagalabe baba na agabidide vye tago vyo vyo na.
God favors you.
Boganja masogamu kama.
A simple word of asking will provide for every need you held for years.
Amen.
When God favors you,
Boganja mu maso ga Mukama,
those you don't know provide for your needs.
Nabo botamanyi bajagabirira ebyetaago byo.
Ladies and gentlemen,
abami n'abakyala,
me and my family, we are seated in a house we did not build with our own resources.
Yes.
But talk about the favor of the Lord. I was telling someone yesterday, for the last 2 years, family that the Lord gave us and we found favor before them.
Waliwo family Katonda gye yatuwa ne tuganja mu maaso gaabwe.
And they asked me and my wife, how much do you need to enter your house?
Ne bambuza nze ne mukyala wange mwetaaga sente mmeko kuzimba enju yammwe gye yingira.
Them the amount.
Ne tubabuulira sente zeetaagisa.
They said we don't have enough to give it at.
But for 2 years,
they've been giving us 2 million every month to put on this
house.
Two years.
You
know what that's called? Favor of the
Lord.
Well, the transfer is happening already, church.
You are
about to own what you did not
build.
In a house you did not even construct.
To be
employed in a place without no application.
Telling you, some
of our daughters about to be married to those rich men.
Abamu kubana abobu wala bana atero kufumbiru haba sajaba bifeke rabia ndala.
Going to happen in a way that you least expect.
Bina atero kutuka umu mangeri jota looza angana ko.
Calling you church, please get excited, get on your toes, because what God is doing.
Penange kanisa tuyimiride, tusanyuke orecho katonda chakola.
Amen. Already in motion, you better move with the move of God.
Katonda yatandika doku tambula nga akola mwekateko.
Amen, church.
Amen.
Not going to die. You are not going to die. You belong to the coming generation.
Kotogenda kufa, ogenda kuba mulamu mulembe guno ogujja.
Leaving you here for purpose.
Katonda kulesewo olw'ekigendererwa.
Survive the massacre of the little boys that were killed in his time as a baby.
Musa yawana okusaddakibwa okwabana abalenza baliwo mu kiseera kye.
Crossover into the next generation.
Nawona nayingira omulembe omulala.
The Lord is preserving us, church.
Katonda tukuumanga ekkanisa atukweka.
The reason of delivering the nation.
Waliwo ensonga y'okununula omulembe.
I just pray that you raise your eyes to see something bigger than what you are seeing.
Nkusaba yimuse amaso gola bet nene okusinga byobadde olaba.
You'll be looking for posture, but God is doing foundation.
Mubadde munonya kawunga ne Katonda alete ekisinga kecho.
Oh, stop waiting for Nabanja. Start waiting on the Lord.
Mulindirire mulekerawo kulindirira Nabanja, mulindirire Katonda.
Don't think Uganda is ending. Uganda is just beginning.
Neba kulimba nganti Uganda egwawo ngambye etandika butandisi.
The pandemic is a sign of an ending generation, but there is a new that's starting with you.
Kino ekirwadde kiranga omulembe ogugwako naye waliwo kipya ekitandika naawe.
Seated in my chair, but I'm jumping up and down in my spirit.
Ntudde mu katabe kano naye omwoyo wange abuuka buuka olw'essanyu.
We will influence Africa. We will influence Africa.
Tugenda kukoma ku Africa tujichuse.
The leaders of the Uganda.
Abakulembeze ba Uganda.
We are the leaders of the church in Uganda.
Yefaba kulembesebe kanisa muno mu Uganda.
Lifting us to be a voice to his church.
Katonda tuyimu sokuwe dobo zirie eriye kanisa.
People come and say, where has Kawempe been for all these years?
Abantu bajja kuvayo bagambe Kawempe kwesiwe banga lino lyonna.
We are in Jethro's house.
Bali mu nyumba ya Yese. Yesero.
But now we are meeting God face to face in the burning bush.
Kakano tugenda kusinka na Katonda maso ku maso mu kisaka ekyaka nga tetizigika.
Wise people. He will introduce us to the elders.
Ajja kutwanjula eri abakulu n'abakadde.
And those very people are going to sponsor our ministries.
Abo bennyini be bagenda okuwagira obuweereza bwaffe.
Abo bennyini ezo sente ze bakuŋŋanyiza nga basamira ne bazimba akeri ne bagula amamotoka. Ezo zennyini ze tugenda okukozesa okubuulira enjiri.
With that very money they have collected to do witchcraft, we're going to use to evangelize. I'm so excited. Allow me to stop here.
2023-2022 revival starts. 2023 tugenda kuowninga ebintu ebyadondolo.
2023 tugenda we're going to own things that are at a cheap price.
Abunga yatandise saving groups temuzivamu muziyingire mutandike okusavinga.
Mr. Kabunga started the saving groups, please join in and start saving.
Mu 2023 tugenda kuyingira Kampala tulamuzake tulamuze mmo ezo simaya za kankwasa simaya za kampire zanye Mukama agenda kuzituwa ku milioni 3 ku milioni 10 milioni 2.
In 2023 we shall enter Kampala and get all those arcades that are kwasa that kamwesi are just 2-3 million in Jesus' name.
Enda kugenda kuzigula nga abazitunda batwegayirira ngulako anko ngulako nange.
We shall buy them at a cheap price when everyone is begging us to buy their property.
Ebyo byonna njogedde leero mbibalangiriyako mwenna abaliko online ne famire zammwe mu linnya lya Yesu.
I proclaim that to happen to everyone who is online with your families in Jesus' name.
Amen.
May everything come to pass in your lives in Jesus' name.
If the modest are not come on your life.
Nsaba amafuta ga Musa okujja ku bulamu bwammwe.
God meet you face to face. May he teach you his ways. May he introduce you to the elders of the city and of the nations. People who have influence to throw you up in your destiny in Jesus' name.
Abantu abasobola okusindikiriza okusula mu magenda go mu linnya lya Yesu.
The Lord release the resources of those bad, evil people back into your hands so you can use them for righteous cause.
Mukama asumulule ebyobugagga n'ebikozesebwa ebiri mu mikono gy'abo ababi babikuddize obikozese okuzimba obwakabaka bwa Katonda.
Declare all that over your life, over your family, over your future in Jesus' name. And I seal it with the blood of Jesus. The enemy shall not steal it from you.
In Jesus'
name.
Amen.